Man, we got some tough news late last night. Stan Savran, just legendary Pittsburgh sports broadcaster for as long as I can remember. We've worked with Stan, passed away. He's been going through a lot of health issues recently. He was 76 years old. He'd been battling lung cancer. He had his right foot amputated back in April. He's dealing with diabetes and stuff. And he'd been off his daily ESPN Radio Pittsburgh show here at iHeartRadio Pittsburgh for a little while now as he was getting better. But I know when people pass, it's like you only say the good things about them. Why do all the good people like just die? I mean, everybody dies, but I don't know, man. It's just like he was such a nice, decent man.
Yeah.
But he treated everyone the same that like worked here with him, you know, and we knew Stan for almost 2 decades.
I mean, just from the random tweets, and I looked at Facebook too, not that I was looking at Facebook for anything but great comments, but it seems like anybody he came in contact with.
Yeah.
Like the average person that saw him out at a restaurant or something, just like, oh, Stan took 5 minutes to talk about the Steelers with me.
Yeah.
And it meant the world to me.
But he would treat.
But that was him here. That was him at the restaurant. That was him at the grocery store. That was him just in life, you know?
He would be talking to your average, everyday, regular person like he would talk to one of our big, higher-up bosses here. That's just who Stan was. And everybody, imagine everybody in a city trying to talk sports with you whenever they see you.
At all times.
That has to be quite the burden to bear. Imagine being, like, going to Giant Eagle.
Yeah, right?
And being so recognizable like Stan was in this city. And every, like, he had to have been so sick of hearing about, like, Matt Canada and the Steelers offensive coordinator position, right?
Constantly.
Just, that is a, he was just a great man, and he worked so hard. That's one of the hardest working dudes that we've ever been around. Like, there were times in the past year where we would see him at work here, right out by the break room. He would sit at the same desk.
Mm-hmm.
And there were times where I'd just be like, I knew what he was going through with his cancer treatments, all that.
His health isn't great.
He'd be at work and I'm like, dude, I miss work when I have like a bad allergies. What are you doing here?
Yeah.
And he just loved talking to people so much and connecting with this city about sports. It was just, it's sad, man. Like, he was going through some stuff, so we all sort of knew that Stan's time was coming to an end here soon, but man, it's
He was still doing call-ins on DVE, like, on their morning show, like, up until, like, a couple weeks ago.
He just couldn't stop working.
No.
Yeah, listen, tune into the DVE morning show this morning. They're going to probably fill their show with Stan tributes, and he was a guest on their show, and he definitely was very close with that show. But rest in peace to an absolute Pittsburgh legend. The one Stan Savran story that we have is, and we've told this before on the show, if you've never heard it, stick around because later in the show, the day that Mac Miller met Stan Savran in our hallways was just a yinsplosion awesome moment. Man, the one thing that I think about, honestly, other than the, you know, like a personal interaction that I think about when I think of Stan Savran, it's me, you, Stan Savran, and Mac Miller. We had Mac Miller up in the studio one day for like an hour, you know?
Mm-hmm.
This was when he was doing one of his hometown stops. He was promoting like a new album. And he just came up in the studio and hung out with us for an hour, Mac Miller. So after Mac is leaving the studio, right? He goes out into the hallway and nobody was with Mac. It was just Mac. He came up himself.
Just came to hang out.
It's just Mac Miller in the studio. And this was, you know, after he had blown up and gotten popular and everything like this. This wasn't like early on Mac. This was like, he's already a big deal, Mac.
Right, right.
So as Mac Miller is leaving our studio, Stan Savran's walking by in the hallway. Mac Miller freaks out. He is so excited that Stan Savran works in our building and passed him in the hallway.
100% true.
So I'm like, hold on 1 second here. This right here is some sort of yinsplosion that needs to. So I'm just like, Stan, can our, I knew that Stan didn't know who Mac was, I don't think. I'm like, can our friend Mac get a picture with you? Oh, yeah, sure. Mac has the biggest smile on his face. You know, because Mac usually would be people taking pictures with him.
Right, right.
No, Mac Miller in the hallway when he saw Stan Savran wanted a picture with Stan Savran. I got to put that picture out, man.
It's classic.
Because Mac is so happy to take a picture with Stan. So obviously we miss our friend Mac, but we wish the best for Stan Savran. He's going through a lot of tough health issues right now. And again, if you feel like it today, if you want to reach out to him on social or, you know, post on his Facebook post about, you know, you're thinking about him or something like that, please show some love to Stan Savran today.